Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about converting units in the English system, particularly length and weight, for this video. So I'm going to use unit conversions to do these, and these are the six problems that I'm looking at, and I have a chart up on top that has the conversions that we need for this video and the next video as well. So when I want to switch from 108 inches into yards, I'm going to use a unit conversion, starting off with the 108 inches, and notice that I don't have a conversion for inches to yards. I could figure out that that's 36, or I could do this in two steps. So I'm going to do the two-step process. So I first want to get rid of inches and go into feet, and I saw from up above that for every 1 foot I have 12 inches, and then I want to do the next step where I want to get rid of feet and go to yards. And I know that there's 1 yard for every 3 feet. So this is the problem I'd have to work. Notice that the inches on top cancel the inches on the bottom, and the feet on top cancel the feet on the bottom, leaving behind yards. And then I could do the math on my calculator. What I have is 108 divided by 12 and then divided by 3, and that's 3. But I also could do 108 divided by, and I could do 12 times 3 is 36 and get 3 as well. So either way you want to think about that. So I have 3, and it's yards because that's the unit that I had left. So 3 yards and 108 inches. What about the second one, 15 pounds into ounces? So I always put the unit that I want to get rid of is on the top with the 1 under it. And then I put those units on the bottom so that they'll cancel. So we have pounds. And then there was, if we look back at our chart, there's 16 ounces in 1 pound. And I put the abbreviation OZ and LB in there for ounces and pounds. So we have 15 pounds and we want to go into ounces. And we know that there's 16 ounces in 1 pound. So we put that conversion there. And in this case, it's the 15 and the 16 are both on the top. So I know I would multiply straight across. Notice that the pounds on the top and the pounds on the denominator or the bottom both cancel, and then I can just do 15 times 16, and that gives me 240 ounces. So whether I multiply or divide depends on where that number ends up in my unit fraction. Okay, the next one was 3.5 miles into yards. So I could start it like this, 3.5 miles over 1 times, and I'm going to say I want to get rid of miles, and I want to end up with yards because that's what the problem said. I can go back up here if I don't recall and look at what the conversion is. There's 1,760 yards in 1 mile. So I'm going to say 1,760 to 1. Now you have a couple options here. If you're using a calculator, you can just multiply 3.5 times 1,760. Or if you wanted to, you could change it into an improper fraction and then multiply it that way, whichever works for you. You're going to cancel the miles. I'm going to go ahead and use my calculator. I'm going to use the fraction button, even though 3.5 is the same as 3.5, but I'm going to do this. 3.5 times 1,760. That's 6,160. What's the unit? Well, the unit is going to be yards because the miles canceled, leaving the yards behind. All right, the next one was 3/4 of a ton into pounds. And I know that there is 2,000 pounds in a ton. The ton is what I want to get rid of. That goes in the denominator. I want to end up with pounds. That goes in the top. And there's 2,000 pounds for every 1 ton. Now maybe you can see that that's 1,500, maybe not. We're going to multiply because the 3/4 and the 2,000 are on the same level. So I have 3/4 times 2,000, and that's 1,500. And the tons cancel, leaving pounds. So our conversion, our unit conversion, because 2,000 pounds is equal to one ton, that's like multiplying by one. When you multiply by one, you don't change the value. Okay, the other ones are 49 inches change into feet and inches, and 95 ounces into pounds and ounces. So what does that look like? Well, 49 inches, I want to get rid of the inches, so I put that on the top and I put the conversion unit on the bottom that I want to cancel. And I'm changing this into feet, and there are 12 inches in 1 foot. So now I can see that I'm going to strike out the inches, and I have 49 divided by 12. So I'm going to write that first as 49 over 12 feet. But how many times does 12 go into 49? And you can use your calculator for this, but it goes in 4 times. So 4 feet plus remainder of what? Well, 12 times 4 is 48, so there's 1 inch left. So it doesn't go exactly in, so we have to do that. What I want you to be careful about, though, if you just do 49 divided by 12, it's going to give you 4.0888. or 333, and that's not what we have here, right? It's not that. It's a remainder, not a decimal answer, but a remainder that we're looking for. So you can think about it in your old division life, where you do this: 12 goes into 49 4 times, with 1 left over, right? That's how I got that 1, not by looking at the decimal. So be careful. There is ways to do that, and if you know how to do it, fine. But my suggestion is maybe just do the division and look at your remainder that way. Okay, the other one was supposed to be changed into pounds and ounces. So I have ounces here, and I have pounds here, and I know that there's 16 ounces in 1 pound. So again, I'm dividing, the ounces cancel, and I'm dividing to find out the pounds, and then whatever's left over is going to be my ounces. And so if I take 95 and divide by 16, I get 5.9375, but 9375 is not the number of ounces I have left, but I can use the 5 because that's going to be helpful. So I'm going to have 5 pounds, and then I can go back and say, well, how many ounces are left then? Well, there's more than one way to do this, but how I'm going to do it is say, well, I know I have 5 pounds times 16, and that's a total of 80 ounces, and that tells me that if I take away the 80 ounces, there's 15 ounces left. So that's going to mean 15 ounces. The other way is just to do the long division like I did here and see after 5 what's the remainder, right? So there's a couple of different ways to do that. Okay, have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.